Welcome back, folks, to Let's Play Solo Brims of Acarnia Shadows Over River. I would like to sleep for 9 days. Apparently, the game cannot handle this. Okay, it looks better. So let's go forward. Whoa. Martian cannot walk. He walks. Like he's drunk. So now we're in better shape. We should be ready to end this. First dungeon, and already so many problems. Did not search this pile. In this corner, you come across a pile of mostly bare bones, with here and there a scrap of clothing. As you get closer, things happen. 5 skeletons rise from the floor and attack. Only 3 points of magic armor. Holy crap! How many damage do they... movement. Oh, I forgot to... switch to... fast combat speed. Move here, so that only 2 can attack us at a time. Don't know how they scream when they're hit. They have no tongue. Tongue. You know, the thing that you have in your mouth. So we had any sort of undead guy here. I should stick with great meat. Okay. Remember to stick with great meat. But none of these pentagrams. Whoa. Not safe here. First, let's see what's in this chest here. Can sell this later. The body of the table is lying quite still. Normally, that would definitely be expected of it, of course, but around here, there have been sightings of undead. The jar set around the corpse's head contained various colors and very pungent herb mixtures. Do you want to conduct a closer examination of the body?
Yes.
Gingerly, Arshin touches the sign of the body's forehead and starts pulling on its skin with the tips of his fingers. Suddenly, he's holding it aloft, without the body showing any change. For a moment, Arshin hesitates, then pulls the skin over his head with a determined gesture. After a short look around, Arshin locates a reflective surface to take a look at himself. Shocked, he stares at the dead man's head. It appears to be sitting on Arshin's shoulders now, and quite alive at that.
Strange. Whoa.
I know what happens here, but I don't know what happens here when a solo character gets in that. Let's see. When Arshin enters the pentagram, things start to get blurry in front of his eyes. The candles give off a narcotic scent, and even though he starts running like crazy, he doesn't make it out of the pentagram. The faster Arshin runs, the further the edges of the pentagram seem to recede. The symbol keeps on growing, and the floor beneath his feet grows ever softer. Until he feels a thought wading through an ocean of blood. Arshin is tired enough to just drop. Every step takes an effort. The walls have disappeared and a dull red glow engulfs the horizon. At some point in time, Arshin notices he is lying in the red fluid, but before he can get up again, everything turns back black. Oh, I'm dead again. When you have more than one character in your party, a second character will rescue the guy who stepped into the pentagram. Well, room is furnished as a laboratory. Whoever is conducting their experiments with the dead here, this is where it all happens. Let's see. Maybe for selling. Let's remember this for selling. There's an alchemist experiment set out on the table. It appears to be coming to a close. Next to it, you see a parchment scroll, possibly containing instructions. Do you want to pick up the scroll?
Nope.
Yes. Is the rice hype here? The slimy green mass in the crucible has become quite vicious by now. You might try to shape it into small balls. I will do this. Expertly, Arshin transfers the boiling mass to an empty container. Take some time for the slime to cool down enough so he can shape it without burning his hands. But in the end, he holds a small green ball. That's all he had material for. Antihypnoticum. And a recipe for antihypnoticum. Let's remember that. Maybe we need this later, folks. Maybe. Anyway, I will be back in a few seconds, guys. See you.